Welcome to The Shape of Things. With our co-host in alphabetical order. From Private Benjamin, Eileen Brennan. From Bosom Buddies, Donna Dixon. From Too Close for Comfort, Nancy Dussault. From 9 to 5, Rita Moreno. From Benson, our guest star leading man, Robert Guillaume. And for some equal time, from New York City, Alan King.
My wife is so ugly that...
You broke the cigar and you didn't let me finish the joke!
And also starring for the woman who has everything, the Chippendale Man. I'd like you to meet a group of talented regular performers on the show.
Hi, I'm Dottie Archibald.
Hi, I'm Rhonda Bates.
Hi, I'm Judy Carter.
I'm Albert Jimenez, thank you.
Hello, I'm Maureen Murphy.
Hi, I'm Howie Mandel. Nice to meet you.
Thank you.
And I'm John Monte.
And I'm Suzanne Rand.
Together, we're Monte and Rand.
And I'm David Ruprecht. And now, it's time for The Shape of Things.
Way to go, little guy.
What a letdown.
Women are the subject of tonight's discussions. That's about the shape of things. Everybody's gonna feel the repercussions coming from the shape of things. Women have an axe and they are gonna grind it. That's about the shape of things. Woo! If there is an answer, we're gonna find it. That's about the shape of things.
That's about the size of the situation. That's about the width of the line. That's about the depth of the degradation. Send it from the ape. And that's about the shape of things.
My girlfriend suspected her husband was cheating on her when she turned on the new dating game and he was bachelor number 3.
This is all the makings of a real nice party. What a perfect shape of things.
You know, things have relaxed a bit these days. Today, a loose woman just means someone who doesn't belong to a health club.
Women in the world are making major changes. That's about the shape of things.
A lot of women want to join the army. I mean, where else would they see 100 men hanging up their own clothes?
Life will be perfection when it rearranges. And that's about the shape of things.
Now, with the passage of the new chastity law, we all know what comes between Brooke Shields and her Calvins. Congress.
That's about the breadth of the brick of crack. That's about the sound of the song and dancing. That's about the shape of a cape. And that's about the shape of things. Wah, 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 wah.
That's about the size and the sound.
And the look and the length.
And the width and the height.
And the depth and the breadth.
And the left and the right.
And that's about the shape of things.
Shape of things. Welcome back to The Shape of Things, an exquisite showcase taken from the feminine viewpoint with panache, with elan, with savoir-faire.
And before we go one step farther, we want to state clearly up front that our primary purpose is not to sock it to men.
Oh, no, our primary purpose is to entertain.
And our secondary purpose is to sock it to men.
Now, now, girls. You see, for years, women were the butt of men's jokes.
So. And vice versa.
Yeah, jokes like this one.
We used to do jokes like this. My wife just learned how to drive. I came home, I found a car in the living room. I said, how'd you get the car in the living room? She said, when I got to the kitchen, I made a right turn.
Cute, cute. You know, jokes like that are just not as funny as they used to be.
We now have a woman who is a Supreme Court justice. And one day, we may have a woman president. And world affairs could go a lot better if she uses all her talent, wisdom, and experience, along with that one intangible that men never really understand. The power of femininity.
Madam President, Mobutu Zimbardo, President of the country of Mbombo.
General Zimbardo.
Madam President, speaking for myself and all of my countrymen, we all hope that under your presidency, the friendship of our two nations will continue to flourish.
Thank you. Please sit down, General.
Thank you.
And may I assure you that I value your nation's friendship as much as my predecessors have, and I hope that we can continue to work together despite the changes in administrations here in America and despite our many differences.
Our differences, Madam President?
Frankly, General, we're concerned and a bit alarmed about the interjection of some of your military personnel and policies into the agreed-upon neutral territories.
Our presence there, Madam President, is a result of the free choice of the people of those territories. In remaining passive, we are in keeping with our treaty commitments.
Well, perhaps in the letter of the law, General Zimbardo, but hardly in the spirit.
With all due respect, Madam President, I have told your former president and the president before him, we have no intention of removing our military observers from those lands.
What are you doing?
Are you crying? Yes, you are. You're crying. Stop crying. I hate to see a president cry. What is wrong with you, Madam President?
Oh, Zimmy. Have you been faithful to us?
What? How can you ask? Well, of course I have. There's no one else.
Oh, how can you lie to me like that?
What do you mean?
We have reconnaissance photographs there. See?
Well, you've been spying on me.
Yes. Well, do you deny it?
All right. I have. I've been seeing Moscow.
Oh.
There's nothing to it, I tell you. It was a mad fling. They offered me a great deal on Missa.
Oh, well, how great can it be?
I just got carried away.
But you have a treaty with a holy vow.
Well, it's not all my fault. When you were supposed to be sending me arms, you spent the money on your beloved hungry children of the world.
Oh, sure. When they're hungry, they're my children.
But, Madam President, I have problems in my country you don't understand.
Oh, so it's come to that, hasn't it? The United States and under Debbie.
Well, that's not what I... That's not what I meant. Please stop your crying.
I can't help it.
Just stop it. Stop it. This instant. All right. I'll sign anything. A new treaty, anything. Oops. Henry Kissinger was never like this. Now, will you stop? Will you be all right?
Are you all right, Madam President?
Sure, this job's a piece of cake. Send in the next guy.
With all the changes in the roles of men and women, it's hard to know how to act on a date these days.
Women are afraid of being thought of as aggressive, and men are afraid of being thought of as chauvinists.
Going out on a date can be very confusing.
Well, here we are. You're gonna love the food here. It's terrific.
Great, I'm really hungry.
Oh, yeah. At least it solves our problem.
Oh, no, after you.
Oh, no, it's just after you.
Oh, no, please, after you.
Cecilia.
You're right. What?
Excuse me, let me.
Oh, thanks a lot.
Thank you.
Yes,
this is really great.
Sorry, you want a chair? I got a chair. Sorry.
This was so good.
Yeah, wasn't it though? It only took us 5 hours to finish.
Well, it wasn't that bad. I mean, after all, it only took us 1.5 hours to decide who should order first.
Yeah, man, 1.5 hours to decide who was going to take the first bite. But it only did take us 30 minutes to figure out who's going to pick up the tab. By the way, thank you for this delicious.
Oh, you're welcome.
Gorgeous. Waiter, could we have our coats, please?
Thank you.
By the way, which one of us is going to drive home?
I think we better walk.
Well, after you.
No, after you.
No,
after you. After you.
Time now to bring you a hot flash.
Latest budget figures show that the government has retained the huge subsidies to the sugar and tobacco industries. However, appropriations to help support public broadcasting have been cut back. So, what you don't see is what you don't get, and what you don't need, you got. Get it?
Yes, you did.
Ladies, if you were walking down the street and saw a man coming towards you wearing a handbag in the shape of a hand, would you, A, cross to the other side quietly, B, look for a police officer, or C, say hello to Howie Mandel? Any of the above is an excellent idea.
Okay, I'll tell you, I'm back again this week with more tips on how to approach women, right? I've been here a few weeks, you can count on me. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah. Just a gag. Okay, No, listen to this, okay? No, women like guys who, like, have a nice car, right? That's true. And that's why I bought a Corvette. No, I did! Okay. No, but if you don't have a nice car, you look stupid. You do look stupid. Women don't like it. Because this is my impression of a guy without a car. You gotta look good, that's important. I've been putting on a little weight. I mean, you can't tell, right, that I'm putting on weight. But 26 years ago, I only weighed about 7 pounds. Oh, I did. Not a close fit or anything. Anyways, listen to this. I wanna tell you something. You know who gets most of the women? Street artists, right? Because they're out at the beach and stuff. And mime is like a big thing. You know mime, like Marcel Marceau? And I wanna show you a piece on how to get a girl's attention in a bar in mime, because mimes get the most. I wanna do it professional, like Marcel Marceau in there. So I got that black shirt. ready? Well, it's black. Okay. And let me just get that. Let me get ready. You see, this is called getting a girl's attention in a bar. Let me just do it. Okay, and so it's a little mistake. All right, but if all else fails, what do you do? What? Oh. Right. Don't go crazy. Okay, if all else fails, this always gets him. Remember this.
I beg your pardon?
Excuse me.
No, not that. The other part.
Negro person?
Yeah. I don't like to be called that, lady.
I'm no lady.
I could tell.
No, I don't like being called lady.
Okay, ma'am.
Or ma'am. I would have hoped you colored people would have
been
by this.
I am not a colored people.
Well, what would you like to be called?
Black.
I see.
Most people do. What would you like to be referred to as?
A woman.
Okay, woman, give me five.
Hey, listen, you want to shuffle off to the left there, Rufus? Tuts, would you move your tuckus?
Oh, where is some?
You've come a long way, baby.
We sure got a long way to go.
When we think of liberated women, we think of women like Bella Abzug, Gloria Steinem, even Eleanor Roosevelt. But when I was a little girl, one of the most liberated women I ever saw was a sensational motion picture actress named Mae West. Someone once said to her, "Oh, goodness, what a beautiful diamond." And she replied, "Goodness had nothing to do with it." What distinguished her from other seductive women of that era was her outrageous comments about her own somewhat awesome sensuality. She was one of the first to come right out and say, "I love the fun, the joy, the humor of romance." My favorite remark was when she turned to her leading man and asked him to peel me a grape, crush me some ice, skin me a peach, save the falls for my pillow, start me a smoke, talk to me nice. You're gonna wine me or dine me. Don't try to fool me, bejewel me, either amuse me. A nut, bring a bowl full of bonbons. Chill me some wine, keep standing by. Just entertain me, champagne me. Show that you love me, keep love me. Here's how to be an agreeable chap. Love me and leave me in luxury's lap. Hop when I holler, skip when I snap. When I say do it, jump to for scotch, boil me a crab, cut me a rose, make a tea with the petals,
Just hang around. Pick up a tab. Never outthink me. Just make me. I didn't say fuck. Hold up there from me. Don't bug me. New Thunderbird me. You heard me. I'm getting hungry. Peel me a grain. Oh, I swear it's such a burden being charismatic. Loved by so many, satisfied by so few. Now, 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 John, let's not be greedy. Pass it on. Well, it's a dirty job. Somebody's got to do it. Going on. Oh, the atmosphere up here is so heavy. I'm getting hungry. Peel me a grave. Hang on, baby. Help is on the way. Poor suckers. And still champion.
Now, in the interest of equal time and fair play, to present the male point of view, here's Alan King and some stupid opinions.
I'm not a male chauvinist, people. I was for the ERA before it was fashionable. But I'd like you women to know that equal rights bring some problems. All of a sudden, women are going to start having ulcers. You never heard about women with ulcers before, did you? Coronaries. Baldness. That's what I'm waiting for. Bald-headed women. That I want to live to see. But you know, the truth of the matter is that we all know women live longer than men. Now, all you got to do is read your obituary pages. It's all men. Women don't die in this country. I showed my wife the obituary pages. She says, isn't it amazing how everybody dies alphabetically? That's why I don't buy life insurance. There's no such thing as life insurance. It's death insurance. If you live, you lose. Only in America are you taught from birth that you're worth more dead than alive. The name of the game is pay the premiums and pay the premiums. The men keep dying, and wherever you go, you see the widows. Charlie would have loved to have been here. He dropped dead trying to pay the premiums. That's why he's not here. Women never buy insurance. You know that a half of 1% of the women in America buy insurance, yet 77.5% of the inherited wealth of this country is in the hands of women. Now, I love it when the agent tries to sell insurance. It's always, Mr. King, after you're gone, will your wife be able to support herself in the style that she's been accustomed to? The only way my wife's gonna be able to support herself in the style that she's been accustomed to is when they dig my grave, they gotta strike oil in the hole. You think it's only my wife? What about my mother? You know what she's been doing to my father for 65 years? Do you know that my father hasn't opened his mouth in a house in 22 years? And do you know that my mother doesn't know that my father hasn't opened his mouth in a house for 22 years? My mother hollers, and my old man just uses his hands. And then she says, don't answer me back, Bernie! You know what my mother does to my father? She grishes him. You know what a grisher is? Let me explain. It's a Yiddish word. Literally translated, it means to twist, to turn. But you don't grisher a screw into a wall. You grisher your husband. When my father got married, he was 6'3". He's 5'2½. Just from... You know, my parents' 65th wedding anniversary, my father said it all. He made a speech. Everybody wants to know how Minnie and I stayed together for 65 years. My father said, hate kept us together. Hate. He said, we'll never die. We wouldn't give the other one the satisfaction. Now, I just hope that my mother and father don't get along for 125 years. And I'd like to say the same thing for my wife and myself. And thank you for coming. Good night.
There is nothing in history that's done as much damage to women's self-esteem, self-confidence, and self-assuredness as the girdle. Look at this. It's a rubber dungeon. Centuries ago, some wacko talked women into wearing something like this and told her that she looked good. That was a lie. She not only looked like a tube of toothpaste squeezed in the middle, but she felt ridiculous. Fortunately, girdles are not as popular as they once were, so it is conceivable that one day soon, they will take their rightful place in society, along with icebox, kerosene lamps, and buggy whips. But before that happens, let's take one last look at a girl and her girdle. Here's Rita Moreno, showing you what we go through getting out of the damn thing. And here's our favorite housewife, Dottie Archibald.
I don't know where you guys live, but I live in Los Angeles in a really high crime neighborhood. So my next door neighbor, Judy, she and I went and took the MACE class so that we could get these little tear gas canisters. You know the ones I mean? I can't wait to use it. Well, it costs $35, you know? But they make all these really dumb rules about it, like, you're not supposed to spray anyone under 18 years of age. Is that so? I mean, I'm gonna be laying on the ground, the guy's gonna be beating me up, and I have to say to him, oh, could I see your driver's license, please? And then you're not supposed to spray him too much because you might hurt him. I want to hurt him. You're supposed to spray him once, and before you spray him again, you have to say to him, are you experiencing any difficulty in breathing? I want him to stop breathing. But the worst thing is the spray only lasts for 10 to 20 minutes. So you can imagine a guy breaks into your house, you spray him, you have him on the bedroom floor, you go over and you call the police. What happens? They put you on hold. Now you're listening to Beatles music. You have to go back and say to the guy, listen, I don't want you to get really mad, but I'm just going to spray you one more time.
There are 220 million people in the United States. Now, that's the population.
And over half of the population is made up of women. Uh-huh. That's where we got the expression, the better half.
Now, these millions of men and women are paired off into groups because the prevailing theory is that people need people.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
No man is an island. Mm-hmm. Two's company, mm-hmm. and it's all in the family.
Hey.
And in the forefront, right there, of that family, is the matriarchal muscle of matrimony, otherwise known simply as the Mrs.
What's here at Paul?
Oh, Mrs.
Oh, Mrs.
Oh, Mrs.
Oh, weary wives, grow bold, can heave a heavy sigh.
Dumpty, may I talk to you?
Yes.
I just want to begin by saying that we're all saddened by the untimely death of your husband.
Thank you.
You didn't live together very long, did you?
We were married in November. We had an incredible winter and a fabulous spring and just a superb summer.
And then he had a great fall. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm only kidding. Just trying to brighten and cheer you up.
What a sense of humor.
For being such a sport, the girl deserves the hugs and kisses. So here comes the bride.
Room out of sight.
Let's all toast the bride. The missus.
Ladies and gentlemen, Judy Carter.
I think I just killed my living bra. Okay, could I have some music, please? Perfect. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to be performing a very ancient feat, this old magic trick, where two solid steel rings mysteriously link upon each other. The illusion of the linking rings! The illusion of the linking ring! Davey! Church. And now, the illusion of the linking rings. One, two, three. Shoot. Illusion of the linking rings.
For our favorite import, Maureen Murphy.
Hello, I am from
from Australia, and it's very exciting for me to be on such a liberated show, because in Australia, we're not liberated. But I always wanted to come here and be an actress, like Olivia Newton-John, who's our Australian 10. I always imagine her coming out on a TV show and saying, I'm so perfect. I'd like to tell you something quite personal. I never have to go. I tried to explain to my mother that I wanted to be an actress. I said, Mother, I want to learn to cry real tears. I want to be able to show great emotion for someone I don't really care for. She said, become a housewife. What she really wants is for me to have a baby, because there's a baby boom now. Even Princess Diana is pregnant, you know. She took the royal pregnancy test. The peasant died. She's going to practice natural childbirth. Can you imagine natural childbirth for a princess? When the water breaks, it's Perrier. They practice natural childbirth a lot here. In California, they even let the husband in the delivery room along with the child's father. And dating is so different here. Like in Australia, a bloke will take you out to dinner, and if you don't come across, he won't ask you out again. It's different in America. Here, you don't get dinner. Only one man called me up and said, would you like to have dinner before I take you back to my apartment? I said, that would be lovely. He said, I'll pick you up about 9. You should have finished eating by then. And then he called me baby all night. He went, hey, baby, prove to me that you're my baby, baby. I did. I dribbled on his shirt.
Fighting back to take junk food out of the schools. This concern has become a national movement. It's moved out into the streets and into the restaurants.
Hi.
Hi.
Here you go, ma'am. Hamburger and coffee.
Oh,
enjoy.
Thanks. Yeah, thanks. This really looks good.
You're not gonna put ketchup on that, are you?
Oh, just a little for flavor.
Well, you do know about ketchup, don't you? I mean, sugar. Lots of sugar. I mean, eat sugar, turn into a diabetic.
Well, maybe I'll just forget the ketchup.
Oh, it's good. You're not gonna leave the lettuce on, are you? I mean, they spray that stuff with chemicals.
But that's what kills the bugs, isn't it?
That's right, honey. And if it kills a bug, it'll kill you.
Oh, I'll just take that off.
Good idea.
How about the tomato?
I'll take it.
Okay. Well, this looks good.
You know, it's really too bad you can't get whole wheat buns. I mean, you do know about white flour, don't you?
Don't tell me, okay? Just take it off.
Just eat the meat. Hamburger meat. Fat, 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 fat. Preservatives, sodium nitrates. Oh. You do know what that does to your body, don't you?
Maybe I'll just drink the coffee. Good.
Oh, I do hope they didn't use tap water when they made that. Did you know that these days that bacteria can withstand the boiling? I mean, can you believe that? It just blows my mind.
How about the potato chip? Okay. Hey, well, that's it for my lunch hour. Well, I guess I better be going. Gosh, just think, you saved my life.
Bye. Well, a person does have to eat. Boy, am I
hungry. Here now are Monteith and Rand.
Is this your first time at the psychiatrist?
Yeah, it's my first time. You know, I'm really kind of nervous about it.
Yeah, me too.
You know, I never thought that I would need a psychiatrist. I thought that they were only for very sick people.
My friends told me I should come.
Really?
Yeah.
So did mine.
Really?
Yeah, yeah. They said sometimes they'd come over to my house.
Uh-huh.
And, well, they said sometimes a totally different personality would answer the door.
Schizo.
But that's what they said. A schizophrenic.
Schizophrenic, yeah. That's what they say about me.
Oh, go on.
Really?
But you seem perfectly healthy to me.
Well, you don't seem to have any trouble relating to me.
I never thought I had any.
Now, it seems awfully silly to spend all this money on a psychiatrist when we obviously don't have trouble relating to people.
Really? You know, this is going to cost me a whole week's worth of tips.
Yeah. You know, we could go out and talk to each other and accomplish the exact same thing.
You're not serious.
Yeah.
Really?
What do we need him for?
Really?
Yeah. Come on. Let's split.
Okay, let's.
Okay.
Mickey Langevin?
Yes?
I'm ready to see you now.
All right, doctor. I'm coming.
A woman's life is full of I'm nots. One of the first is...
I'm not going to school.
Then there are the others that crop up over the years.
I'm not wearing braces.
I'm not wearing a train in anything.
I'm not going to the dance.
I'm not going to the dance with him.
I'm not going out with him again.
I'm not getting engaged.
And today, all of those I'm nots lead up to the biggest I'm not of them all.
This day, pinnacle of life, husband unto wife, the heart leaps up to behold this golden day.
Pardon me, is everybody there? Because if everybody's there, I'd like to thank you all for coming to the wedding, and I appreciate you going even more. I mean, you must have liked the better things to do. Not a word of it to Paul. Remember, Paul, you know the man I'm going to marry, but I'm not, because I wouldn't ruin anyone as wonderful as he is. Thank you all for the gifts and the flowers. Thank you all. Now it's back to the showers. Don't tell Paul, but I'm not getting married today. Listen, everybody, look, I don't know what you're waiting for. A wedding, what's a wedding? It's a prehistoric ritual where everybody promises fidelity forever, which is maybe the most horrifying word I've ever heard, which is followed by a honeymoon. Well, suddenly he'll realize he's saddled with a nut and want to kill me, which he should. Thanks a bunch, but I'm not getting married. Go have lunch, because I'm not getting married. You've been grand, but I'm not getting married. Don't just stand there. I'm not getting married. And don't tell Paul, but I'm not getting married today. Go, can't you go? Why is nobody listening? Goodbye, go and cry at another person's wake. If you're quick for a kick, you could pick up a christening. But please, on my knees, there's a human life at stake. Listen, everybody, I'm afraid you didn't hear. If you want to see a crazy lady fall apart in front of you, it isn't only Paul who may be ruining his life. You know, we'll both of us be losing our identities. I telephoned my analyst about it, and he said it's the money, but my money I'll be floating in the Hudson with the other garbage. I'm not well, so I'm not getting married. You've been swell, but I'm not getting married. Clear the hall, because I'm not getting married. And thank you all, but I'm not getting married. And don't tell Paul, but I'm not getting married today.
Bless this bride, totally insane, slipping down the drain. And bless this day in our hearts as it starts to rain. This day is for
everyone. Oh, can't you go? Don't you know? I adore you all, but why? Why don't you die like Eliza on the ice? Look for her. Tell you, but I may be coming down with hepatitis, and I think I'm gonna faint. So if you want to see me faint, I'll do it happily. But wouldn't it be funnier to go and watch a funeral? Thank you for the 27 dinner plates, the 37 butter knives, the 47 paper weights, the 57 candle holders.
One more thing.
I'm not getting married.
Softly said.
I'm not getting married.
With this ring.
I'm not getting married.
Easy when.
I'm not getting married.
Let us pray.
I'm not getting married.
Let us pray.
I'm not getting married today.
modern-day world, you can't be just a man or a woman. Seems nowadays everybody's got to have a label. You're either a visionary, a revolutionary, a missionary, a reactionary, or you're ordinary. You're either opinionated, dominated, liberated, or expatriated. Not to mention being a fundamentalist, a moralist, a sexist, a racist, a fascist, a Marxist, a Maoist, a revisionist, or an anarchist. Seems only fair that we remember back to a more simple time when men were knights, women were ladies. And the only word they had in common was a four-letter one called love. Lady, I'm your knight in shining armor, and I love you. You have made me what I am, and I am yours. My love, there's so many ways I want to say I love you. Let me hold you in my arms forevermore. You have gone and made me such a fool. I'm so lost in your love. Won't you believe in my song?
Folks, it's been good for us.
And we hope it's been good for you.
And remember, that little girl sitting on your lap today may just be the president sitting in the White House tomorrow.
And then the shape of things might look a whole lot better.
So take good care of our future president.
Good night. Good night.
Johnny's back on The Tonight Show, starring Johnny Carson. Join him as he welcomes Paul Sorvino and Andy Williams. Then stay tuned for Late Night with David Letterman. Ad libber par excellence, says Daily Variety. Tomorrow night, an all-new Real People takes you inside a UFO. Then, after the facts of life, catch the new hit series Teachers Only. And don't miss Quincy, all on NBC.
Look how I wasted an hour. I could have been watching Gilligan's Island.